Today, we'll learn how to add the double exposure effect to your videos in Final Cut Pro. We'll take a look at three different examples, each one getting progressively harder. Let's start with the easiest one. What you need for this effect is a shot of a dark subject silhouetted against a light background. All the black in your clip will be completely transparent. Everything that's white will be opaque, and all the colors and shades in between will be semi-transparent. This first clip will only need a few minor adjustments to blow out the background and darken our subject. Add a color wheels correction. Grab the highlights exposure control and drag it all the way up until the background is completely white. If your pointer gets all the way to the top of the wheel but the background isn't completely white, you can just keep dragging up until it's completely blown out. Next, grab the shadows control and bring it all the way down until your subject is nice and dark. Adjust the mid-tone exposure to show more or less detail around the edges. Remember, anything that's not black or white will be semi-transparent. Next, grab the second clip you want to use for this effect and layer it directly above your first clip. This is the easy part. To blend these two clips into a double exposure, select the top clip and in the video inspector, from the blend mode drop-down menu, select screen. This blend mode makes your second clip visible through a silhouette for this cool double exposure effect. Our next clip is a bit trickier. Because the subject in our clip is wearing a light shirt, it would be very hard to blow out the background without blowing out our subject with a color correction. In cases like this, using the Luma-Keyer would be a better choice. Press Command 5 to open the effects browser, and from the keying category, select the Luma-Keyer. Add this effect to your clip. In the video inspector, switch to matte view and drag the black point all the way to the right until your subject is almost completely black. Grab the white point and drag it left until the background is completely white. Play around with these controls until you have just a little bit of detail left in the subject, so just a bit of gray, which will be semi-transparent. Add your second clip above your timeline, and in the video inspector, change the blend mode to screen. If you want to leave a little bit of detail in the sky of the original clip, select it, and in the inspector, switch back to composite view in your Luma-Keyer tools. Personally, I think plain white background looks much better, so I'll go back to the map view. Whichever option you have selected is what your final export will look like. Here's my result. Before we move on to our last example, I want to take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Whether you need a stock clip to use as part of your double exposure effect, royalty-free music or sound effects to make your video more engaging, or a unique title to make your project stand out, Envato Elements has what you're looking for and more. For one low monthly fee, you get unlimited access to almost 60 million digital assets, including stock video, royalty-free music and sound effects, video templates, graphic templates, web templates, still images, and so much more. And with new items added every week, their library just keeps growing. So whether you make videos for a living or posting videos online is just a hobby, you need to check out Envato Elements. You can try it risk-free for 7 days, and if you don't love it, simply cancel your subscription before your trial expires and you won't be charged a single penny. Trust me, a subscription to Envato Elements will help you make better videos. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. In our last example, the luminance levels of our subject and the background are very similar, so it would be nearly impossible to separate them by adjusting exposure or by using the Luma-Keyer. What we can do though, is isolate specific colors and overexpose them for a white background. Go to the color inspector and add a hue saturation curves correction. Scroll down to the hue versus luma curves, select the eyedropper tool, and first, use it to sample a sky in our clip. Grab the middle control point and drag it all the way up to blow out the sky in this clip. Next, use the eyedropper tool to sample the color of the ocean in this clip. In the hue versus luma curves, you get a line that represents this color. Click on the curve line to add another control point and drag it all the way up. Adjust these control points until you blow out as much of the background as possible. To take care of the rest, let's add a color wheels correction and bring up the highlights exposure control all the way up. Adjust the midtones and shadows until you get a nice silhouette of the subject while retaining a little bit of detail. Add your second clip on top of this one and change the blend mode to screen for this cool double exposure effect. If you found this video helpful or learned something new from it, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.